We will talk about augmented reality and openness in education, OER specifically. We're here with Martin. He is from the Netherlands, from the University in Delft. He is working at the Faculty for Architecture, and one of his main emphasis in his work now is AR and education and online learning. So let's start with a very basic question. How is AR a thing now in 2019, 2020?
Well, AR is not yet what it will be in the end, but it's in startup. And like VR, maybe 5 years ago, AR is now coming up. And I think it will be really big in 2 to 5 years. And it will be all around in education. And now it's still possible to do it on your mobile device. And in some years, it will be Google's.
And how does it help for education?
It really involves the students on their subject. So I always say it's contextual and behavioral, because students can walk around the content and they can, like in some science fiction series, you see them all standing around digital objects, and that's possible in education as well. So people can collaborate and exchange things.
And I learned that students can not also see the objects but also create their own objects. Is it true?
Yeah, I teach my students to use simple workflows to create their content. For example, by taking pictures from their scale models, or by using simple CAD software. And then it's quite easy to make something 3D.
And how much do open licenses play a role in this?
Of course, it has all the flavors of openness, like text or images. But when you make it, you can share it on a repository like Sketchfab, and that's a really nice, it's like YouTube, but then for 3D. And it allows to choose if you want to get paid for it or that you do it totally free. And I use another software, which is called Torch. And it's a kind of software to make compositions of several assets. And immediately when you drag and drop your content in it, it generates the right license text for you.
That would be helpful for any other resources, so that you do not have to find out, these were the 10 objects and these are the 10 licenses. Does it by drag and drop?
Yeah, by drag and drop. And well, that's of course the way of software can be integrated. So this software I use is really using the method of open source in the right way. I can give you a demo if you like. So
okay, we'll do a bonus track now and you show me how the software works. Maybe we just ask Chris, our video producer, to come behind us so he can take a video from your screen, and we will show what it looks like and unhold the microphone. We just have to find out.
I will also record the screen so that you might use it later on for your video. I use the software Torch, and it's authoring on your mobile telephone. So you don't have to do transformations and so on. You can just work on it in real life. So now you saw already that the software detects the ground and I place an anchor. The anchor point is the zero point for your 3D world. And then we can add something. And we use Sketchfab, that's the repository for 3D things. And now let's improvise. What would you like to see as content here in this room?
I would like to see an elephant in the room.
Okay, let's try. So, like in a Google search, you elephants elephant. It has to look for it. So there are a number of elephants, and I like this realistic one. So I pull it in, like drag and drop, and there it is. And I take this away. I can position it, and now it looks like a baby elephant. I can make it more big. And yeah, it's there's really an elephant in the room. And well, there's much more in this app that you can do all kinds of interactions. I will not show that today, but here is a nice thing. You can make this attribution list for the credits. And it's immediately generated. And here is the elephant by Onderon Vermes, licensed under CC attribution. If I click on that, we come on the Sketchfab site, and you get all information from the author, the original author of this elephant. So yeah, it works.
Okay, I think this was the first video we did with an elephant in the room. Is it an actual elephant? Well, that's a philosophic question.
It's a saying. Let's talk about that later on.
Okay. Thanks for the interview. Thanks for showing us the elephant. All the best for your work. Thanks again,
for
Martin.
Having me. Thank you. Bye.